Hey Halloweenies, I'm Ozzy the Horror Cub. Take a trip with me to Haddonfield because it's time to review Halloween Resurrection. Let's get into it. Released in 2002 and directed by Rick Rosenthal, this would be the film that would see Busta Rhymes come face to face with Michael Myers and Kung Fu chop him off a window. What were they thinking behind this movie? This would also be Jamie Lee Curtis's last Halloween movie, in this timeline at least. Because after this movie was completed, we go into the Rob Zombie timeline, which is a completely rebooted storyline of the Michael Myers mythos. It wasn't until 2018 that we would see Jamie Lee Curtis return to the property in David Gordon Green's Halloween. The movie opens with dispelling how Halloween H20 ended. Now, Halloween H20 for me has one of the best endings of the entire Halloween series. Laurie standing there decapitating her brother, looking triumphant. It gives me life. It gives me everything that I need. She is our final girl, and then to see this film that she's defeated and that she's been placed into a mental asylum because it turns out that a paramedic's body was switched with Michael. We cut back to Hillcrest Academy in 1998, where the events of Halloween H20 took place. Michael switches out his body with a paramedic. It's the paramedic that is pleading with help with Jamie. She's the one that decapitates him. It wasn't Michael Myers. Michael Myers gets away scot-free, and he's been trying to track down his sister ever since. I hate how this movie retcons Halloween H20's ending. Halloween H20, you are a genius movie. This movie should have just rebooted the storyline, or they could have found a much clever way to go about this. I don't appreciate this film. This film is one of the lowest ranked Halloween movies in my franchise ranking. I just don't appreciate the tone of it. It doesn't feel like a Halloween movie. There's no nostalgia to it when you watch this movie. The opening credits, they don't even give me life. The opening credits since this point in the Halloween franchise, we've gotten these great pumpkin openings, or we've gotten these iconic shots of October settings, really getting you into the Halloween spirit. These are just black title cards with the names popping up in orange font. It is not spooky and I am not having it. Rick Rosenthal, you directed Halloween 2 from 1981. It is one of my favorite Halloween sequels. That film gives me life because to me, it feels so closely to John Carpenter's original, taking place the exact same night as Halloween 1978. I really did think that Rick Rosenthal would bring some life to this project, would really bring the Halloween franchise back on a course that it needed to be on. This movie doesn't do it for me though. This movie doesn't even feel like it's a Halloween movie, and I think that says a lot about Rick Rosenthal's directing. I think Halloween 2 is a better film just because Dean Cundey was the cinematographer. He was the cinematographer behind the original Halloween, he was the cinematographer in Part 2, and although you lose Carpenter as director for Part 2, Rick Rosenthal does his best to stand in, but it's really Cundey's work that's shining through. Watching Halloween Resurrection, I don't feel inspired, I don't feel like I'm watching a great Halloween movie. This just feels pedestrian, it feels like trash. To have Jamie Lee Curtis killed off in the first 10 minutes, and I know she wanted out of the Halloween series at this point, but you know what you do? You don't kill Jamie Lee Curtis this way. Jamie Lee Curtis is our final girl. We've been with her for 3 movies already. She's basically carried this franchise. You don't do her so dirty by having her go out as your opening kill. You save Jamie Lee Curtis for the very end of this movie, and as that shitshow bonfire is going on in the garage between Sarah and Michael, that's where you have Laurie Strode come in. That's where you have Laurie Strode go down with the boogeyman, go down with her brother, and I would have been happy with that. You could have still have ended the movie with Michael's eyes popping open the way that it does in the morgue. I would have been completely fine, but at least Jamie Lee Curtis's character would have gone down with some dignity, because girl, there ain't no dignity in this movie. The way that she goes out, she is stabbed in the back. I'm not having it. I know that Laurie Strode would want to have closure in regards to figuring out, is she killing the right person again? I'm sorry, but if a bitch stalks you up to a roof, that's Michael Myers. And you know what? In my head, that was Michael Myers in the autopsy truck, and you can't convince me otherwise. Kevin Williamson, the writer of Scream, was actually the person that proposed this ending for Halloween H20. Jamie Lee Curtis was about to walk off production. She really did want to kill Michael Myers for good. That's why Halloween Resurrection to me just feels like the ultimate betrayal to her character, to the continuity. But you know what? I'm glad that they rebooted the storyline, and we're moving in a fresh new direction with Halloween Kills, because girl, this movie is a dumpster fire. After Laurie's death, Michael then goes back to his childhood home. Now here, he's discovering that Dangertainment has been set up. Busta Rhymes' character, Freddy, has basically overtaken Michael Myers' childhood home. Him and Tyra Banks are gonna be doing it all out because they've got this internet reality program that they're gonna be broadcasting on Halloween night. It's called Dangertainment. So Dangertainment is this production environment that's moved into the Myers house. They've set up cameras throughout the entire Myers house, and they've got a bunch of kids that are coming in, and these are gonna be the main characters that we're gonna be following along. Sarah and her ragtag group of friends. Cannon fodder, that's all these characters are, they're cannon fodder. They're gonna be going into the Myers house, and they have to survive one Halloween night there. Now, they don't know that Michael Myers has been living underneath the house, that he's been practically there for the past 20 years. Michael is pissed seeing these people in his house, and he starts taking them all out one by one. The characters are all forgettable. I mean, you got that kid from American Pie. You ain't giving me any zhuzh. How did Michael Myers Candyman him? Were the walls super thin? I don't understand how it happened. Interesting premise, though, having this reality concept and having the camera strapped to all the characters' head. Yes, it's giving me Blair Witch Project vibes, because the Blair Witch Project happened in 1999, so they are capitalizing off the success of that. However, reality show competitions weren't really a big thing, but you didn't really have the reality that we have today. So this movie, looking at it through the lens of a 2021 movie viewer, it is quite interesting. It does kind of hold up the concept that they've created. It's just it wasn't executed properly. And I really wish Rick Rosenthal would have did his best to try and put effort into this movie. It just doesn't feel like any effort was placed into it. The score is abysmal. The lighting is atrocious. Michael Myers' mask is a step up from Halloween H20, having four different masks. But girl, let me tell you something. He looks painted for filth. Why does his mask look like that? And in certain times, is he wearing eyeliner? I'm all for guyliner, but is he wearing eyeliner? Those are supposed to be the blackest eyes, the devil eyes, and he's using Maybelline mascara, girl. I couldn't believe it. When I saw this movie when I was 12, I was like, what is this movie? It just didn't make sense to me that this was all happening. Sarah is the lead final girl in this movie. She's supposed to be the new Laurie Strode in a sense. Shy, meek, timid. Let me tell you something about the character that actually portrayed her. Girlfriend couldn't even scream. They actually had to dub in all of her screams throughout the film. And what is going on with this subplot that she's got a boyfriend in high school and he's doing her homework for her? Decker, I think you need to get out, okay? They could have just enjoyed that Halloween party that they were at, but no, he had to watch this girl in college run through Michael Myers' house with the dub screaming. I hate the characters in this movie. I hate the dialogue. I don't think that there's anything really redeemable in this film. When I see Buster Rhymes karate chop Michael Myers out of a window, I know that the movie's done for me. And the movie was done for me. The second I saw that, the second I just saw the betrayal of how they handled Michael Myers' character, I was done. They betrayed Laurie Strode. They betrayed all of us. I just feel like Dimension Studios, Mustafa Akkad, you did us all dirty with this movie. The premise is cool, it needs to be cleaned up. Halloween Resurrection, you are the absolute lowest on my Halloween franchise ranking. I absolute hate watching you. I understand that this movie has built a little bit of a cult following here and there, because people do defend this movie on TikTok. They do get some enjoyment out of it. However, for me as a Halloween fan of the original 1978, this didn't feel like a spiritual sequel, it feels like a betrayal. For that, I'm gonna give Halloween Resurrection a 4 out of 10. Why didn't they show Tyra Banks' death? Girlfriend could have smized to death as Michael Myers was strangling her. They did Tyra Banks dirty by not having her death. Let me know, do you like Halloween Resurrection? Are you more of a fan of it than I am? Let me know down below in the comments. Don't forget to hit that subscription button and smash that like, because we're going to be reviewing Rob Zombie's reimagining of John Carpenter's original Halloween. Until next time, stay spooky.